Journey with Judy. Honest, open, transparent. It's hot.
There's no such thing as perfect people. There's no such thing as a perfect life. So come as you are, broken and scarred. Lift up your heart and be amazed and be changed by a perfect God.
Okay, so I'm definitely starting today's show bawling my eyes out because there's just so many lessons that I got to keep learning. And there's something about continuing to be given the opportunity by God to learn the lessons that we most need to learn, you know, like, and I love that he just gives you enough light for the step that you're on. And then he smacks you like right upside the head with a 2x4. So here's the deal, friends. Get on your knees or he's going to break your legs. It's just the way he works, and I love him for that. So thanks for choosing to journey with Judy this Sunday morning. I'm running on empty a little bit because volleyball's just killing me, Dave. Last weekend, Memorial Day weekend, which I was so happy for all the people that come up, you know, for the weekend, that they had some seriously great weather to make some super memories and be mindful of the sacrifices that others have made for that to happen. But while you guys were digging it, all the weather, great here weather here in Wisconsin, I spent 36 hours in the Rosemont Sports Dome, volleyballing, as Bob calls it. We're going volleyballing. And you know what? I don't complain about that because here's the deal. Well, the things you look at change when you change the way you look at things. And my perspective of getting to watch both of my daughters, but more importantly at this moment in time, my daughter Kennedy, return to the thing that she loves the most is just such an incredible get to. So as my man and I were having a 4 a.m. wake up call on Saturday and Monday morning, Bob took the Sunday morning shift for me, thank God. But nonetheless, we traveled to the Rosemont Sports Dome. And as we were walking in, I was walking in with my son Carter and I was saying, you know, I'm guessing that this is going to be a low key event. You know, the good news is you get to watch your sister play post almost dying in a car accident 120 some days ago. But it's going to be like a low key thing because really, who else would possibly want to spend the whole weekend at the Rosemont Sports Dome other than the Hare family? Well, I'm here to tell you that everybody apparently wanted and got to spend their weekend watching their daughter do what all those kids love to do, which is play this sport at the next level at such a competitive degree that most of their goals, Dave, is to play at the next level. They want to play college volleyball. Well, let's be mindful of the fact that we were watching 15-year-old volleyball. The oldest girls in this gym, Dave, for three weekends or in this sports dome were 16. Oh. Here's what blew me away. Was who was watching. Dave, these are the coaches and the colleges they represented, the recruiting coaches that we saw the first 5 minutes on the scene. Penn State, Notre Dame, Michigan State, Ohio, Northwestern, Purdue, Auburn, Florida State, Texas, South Carolina. Come on, are you kidding me, Dave? Louisville, Illinois, Wisconsin, North Dakota, Pittsburgh, Marquette, Georgia Tech. Now, those are only the ones that I happened to see standing around the court that my daughter was playing on. And it just seemed like every single parent, and more importantly, every single player was just so impacted by the fact that these people were watching. Like, there were crazed parents, there were pressured athletes, there were anxious coaches. And you know, for that one moment in time, the perspective I had on Kennedy playing volleyball, it started to get skewed. I started thinking like those parents. I started losing sight. And the fact that what God has done in my daughter's life is so far surpasses what it would look like he was doing or was going to do. But you know what? Let's be honest, open, and transparent. These coaches represent $150,000 to $200,000, Dave. That's what they're carrying. That's what those full-ride scholarships are worth. There's these girls that are in eighth grade that have committed 4 years of college, 4 years before college. That's right, and they're in high school. And some of them in eighth grade. It is so crazy. And you know what? Here I am feeling like my perspective is so demented when the reality is, see, I know that God's plan and God's purpose and God's timing is everything. And it's so much bigger than the way something looks or the way something feels or the way something appears to be, right? Am I right or wrong? But here's the other thing. There's so many things that I thought about as I was watching this unfold for 36 hours was Kennedy started out being watched by the best of the best. And when her team moved from the winner bracket to the loser bracket, and you know, when people say you're a loser, I mean, I wore that label for a really long time, and I barely put on willingly the winner label now, knowing that in the eyes of God, I am that and no longer a loser. But the reality is I physically watched them with my own two eyes not only turn their back on Kennedy's team, but like downright look down and walk away and actually dismiss. They actually dismissed the girls as being worthy of being watched. And is that crazy, Dave? Like, these people are deeming these girls worthy or unworthy, right? And that's a bummer to me. So anyway, we got to trust in God's timing. We got to trust that sometimes it feels like he's late, but he is never delayed. He is always on time, and his time is the perfect time. So we don't want to get out of anything prematurely because there's work that's got to be done before we get out of it. And the work is the hardest part. So, and it's also hard to go to a break. You are journeying with Judy right here on Lake 96.1. We will be back. Okay, so our show this morning is talking about who's watching. It's talking about being on your game every time, all the time, regardless of who's watching. It's about knowing that God is always watching. That's a quote I recently sent to one of my kids. I saw that, God. Because here's what I know when it comes to this whole recruiting process. Nothing. I know absolutely nothing. But I do know that if God has a plan for our life, that he and only he will be able to bring it to fruition regardless of what it looks like, regardless of what it feels like. And so the bottom line is, I don't know about you guys, but I always want to get to the end of the story. Because see, I know everything will be okay in the end. And I know if it's not okay, then it's not the end. And so for the sake of my kid, I mean, I stepped into that skewed vision of my daughter not being good enough, because sometimes when I was watching her over the weekend and these coaches were there, she didn't have her A game. And I got sucked into that trap of believing that they really controlled her destiny. And that's so not okay, because our verse today says, don't try to get out of anything prematurely. Let it do its work in you so you become mature and well-developed. And I don't know, I'm not the only parent who wants that for their kids. I just know that I'm not. And I'm definitely not the only parent who doesn't want their kid to make the same mistakes. And so I got to believe what it is that I am trying to teach and preach to my kids, which is God's time is always the right time. And because you might feel like you're delayed in something, it's never a denial. But it is definitely so hard to hold the vision while you're trying to trust the process, right? So when we start comparing, we know that comparison is the death of contentment. And I know that my kid, Kennedy especially, because she's in that bracket of being viewed and, you know, by these coaches and things, and she has a vision for what her plan is for her life. And I hope it's what God's plan is, because then I know it's going to happen. I know that it's going to happen. But I have to keep reminding her to be so mindful, not to be in a hurry to get to the next stage, because we exhaust so much energy trying to get to the next stage, and God isn't even there yet. See, we feel frustrated with this seemingly so slow progress that's happening, but here's what Campbell brought to mind. Campbell said, Mom, It's impossible to play your best when you know they're watching because they get in your head and you can't get them out. So the reality is, I don't care if it's when we're competing athletically or we're on our job or we're engaging with our kids or our spouse or people we love, we got to bring our A game all the time, every time. Not only because somebody's watching, because God is always watching and he's always wanting to come alongside of us and pour into us what it is that we need to bring our A game all the time and every time. Campbell also mentioned that Kennedy had her worst outing ever. Kennedy goes, wow. Kennedy was blaming all. It was so funny because Ken's like, well, if my team would have done this and I wouldn't have do that. And Campbell's like, straight up, honest, open, and transparent. Get over yourself. It wasn't your best outing. Accept responsibility. And it's true, like, we want to be blaming everybody else for the thing that we didn't do because we didn't step up our A game. It's because you didn't do what I needed you to do and say what you need I needed you to say and be who I needed you to be, when the reality is we get to allow something to do its work in us regardless of what is happening in the lives of the people around us. So we get to become mature and developed in God's time. And you know what the other thing Campbell said is, once they get a scholarship, they take their foot off the gas. Now, this is a 12-year-old little girl assessing a situation, and whether that's wisdom or Campbell's opinion, I thought there's got to be some truth to that. Like, once we know we got something, do we continue to press forward with the same deliberate, intentional purpose? I guess marriage. I've seen that quote recently. If you want to have a good marriage, do what you did in the beginning of your marriage, right? Or when you first come on the scene of a job or whatever it is, when you know that everybody's watching you, you step up to your A game every single time. And see, this thing about these processes, I almost want this thing to happen for my daughter like it happened for my son when it comes to recruiting. This long process, developing character, working out what it is they really, really want. And do they, at the end of the day, really, really want it? Because, see, God would wait a whole lifetime in order for something to be perfected in us so he can use us and continue to prepare us for our role in the bigger picture that he calls eternity. See, it took 80 years to prepare Moses for his journey, which, by the way, at like 14,600 days, he's going, hello, is it my time yet? And God's going, it's so not your time, but it is my time. And I love that quote that says, be patient. God is not finished with me yet. And see, the thing about walking with God is we just have to keep walking. See, I just told Dave before we started the show, is I want to get to the other side of everything. But I know, more importantly, the work that has to be done in the process, the work that has to be done in me. And when I try to get out of something prematurely, or even worse, allow my children to get out of something prematurely before God's time, then see, it doesn't happen the way it's supposed to. Because when God wants to grow an oak tree, it takes 100 years. I'm going to be dead. If it takes 100 years to get my kids to heaven, I'm going to be dead. But the alternative is I can have a little mushroom that grows overnight. See, great souls are grown through struggles and storms and seasons of suffering. But as a parent, as a person of faith, like, I got to be patient with the process and I got to act on what I remember the most, which is, if it doesn't challenge you, it doesn't change you. And if it's not God's plan, it's not going to happen. So slow and steady runs the race. Slow and steady and surely, as time approaches, the vision's going to be fulfilled. But it's not our vision. It's God's vision, which is more than we could ever ask, dream, or imagine. And I'm pretty sure the vision for Dave is that I say goodbye. So I'm going to go to break. I got to say pause. And if our farmers were waiting for us to show up on the scene and watch what they are doing, and as we celebrate June being Dairy Month, I got to give a shout out to the state of Wisconsin that produces 14% of all milk, Dave. Hello. 26% of all cheese in the United States comes from Wisconsin. And how about this? Wisconsin is the top country producing cheese. Now, you know I'm you know that I'm geographically challenged, which is why you're challenging me. On the graph, it clearly gives Wisconsin as the one of the top producing countries. So it says the U.S., Netherlands, Germany, Wisconsin. That's how much cheese we are producing. And friends, there's 600 kinds of cheese. So we earned and we owned our name, Cheesehead, right? Did we or did we not? And that's thanks to the 10,860 number. That's the number of licensed U.S. dairy, Wisconsin dairy cows. No. Wow. Okay, isn't that crazy? Okay, so forget about who's watching, because Noah's watching our farmers who are sowing and reaping day and night. And you got to love that. I got to thank two of my sponsors. One, Greg Kunis. Thank you. Thank you for sponsoring my show. And then my farmer friend from Holstein Dairy. Thank you. You are journeying with Judy right here on Lake 96.1. I totally dig Mandisa. Like, you talk about putting things in the proper perspective. She starts off this song by saying, I could never say enough to thank you. See, a disposition of gratitude is where it all starts. A thank you for every get-to. For every get-to that we tried to get out of, but God wouldn't let us. For every opportunity that God allowed us to go through to get to the other side more mature and more well-developed. And it doesn't matter if it has to do with recruiting, or it's every situation and every condition of life. See, the only time we're supposed to look back is to see how far that we've come. And we've got to get out of our mind the fact that a rejection is not a rejection. It's a redirection to continue to walk on the path with faith, trusting not only in God, but trusting in His timing. See, one of the ways that we can do that is to remember the promises from the past. See, if we remember what God has done, it encourages us to wait and trust in His timing. If we are really believing that God will work and that He is at work, it's almost a no-brainer. See, she's singing and saying this shouldn't be complicated. It shouldn't be hard to see. It's not about what I do for you. It's what you've done for me. And what did He do? He gave His life. He gave everything. And all we got to want to do is give it back. We talked about that last week. Open hands, standing before God saying, take what it is that you don't want me to have and give what it is that you want me to. And sometimes when we're in a season of our life that's just, I don't know, like where you can't breathe, it's those times that God's saying, don't try to get out of this prematurely. Let it do its work in you so you become mature and developed. See, God's never in a hurry, but He's never late. You are exactly where you're supposed to be. I often wonder if I prayed as much about something as I do talk about it, if things would be different. You know what I'm saying, Dave? Like, I know that I beat a dead horse, and a lot of times my kids say to me, Mom, I've heard that like 100 times. And I think that you have to hear something a certain amount of times before it actually sinks in, because I do always overcomplicate this. I don't walk in my faith, especially when it comes to my kids. See, I want so much to get them out of something prematurely, because I don't want them to end up down the paths that I've chosen to take, because many people don't recover from that. But here's what I got to know that I know that I know, and I want you to know this morning as we wrap up the show, is that when we get out of something prematurely, we don't allow God to perfect the work that He's begun in us. See, God is in charge, and He is on time, and He is faithful when we are not. So regardless of the path that the people you love are traveling, regardless of who they think may or may not be watching, God sees everything. And He is always coming alongside of us to give us a do-over, to remind us that His plan is always perfect. And it is better than we ever thought, ever dreamed or could ever imagine. And it's Dave, it's worth way more than $150,000 or $200,000 scholarship. That's a commercial for like being priceless. Because I'm telling you that you are exactly where you need to be. And instead of saying to God, show me and in the end I'll trust you, God just looks right at us and says, trust me and in the end I'll show you. Because he makes a way where there doesn't even seem to be a way. And I dig that. We got to wrap it up, but we first go to break. You are journeying with Judy right here on Lake 96.1. Okay, so this week, let's step up our game. Let's give our very best all the time, regardless who we think is watching, because God is watching all the time and every time. And for every time we try to get out of something prematurely, let's be mindful of the fact that we gotta let the work be done on the inside so we too become mature and well-developed. I want that day for me and all the people I love and definitely all the people that journey with me every week right here on Lake 96.1. So this week, keep it hot, honest, open, and transparent. Peace out!